Good morning, everyone. Without further ado, we'll go ahead and begin our training today on Aria audio distribution your way. The concept of this training here is to arm you with the tools necessary to encounter any multi-room audio system and be able to spec the right product to ensure that you land the job. With that being said, my name is Troy Barron. I am the National Sales Manager for Channel Vision Technology, and I'll be your host today. And I'll be taking you through this little learning exercise that we're going to go through today, give you guys the opportunity to make a little more money and offer something unique to your customers. For those of you who are not familiar with Channel Vision was founded 20 years ago in the garage of our CEO, Daryl Hawk. The company was built exclusively on the needs of our customers and continues to strive to be a unique manufacturer to meeting the demands of our customers today. Over those 20 years, we've grown to be a larger company with our own manufacturing facility and our own QC process here in California. So like I said, if you're not familiar with Channel Vision, we do a lot more than just audio distribution. We're one of the largest structured wiring manufacturers in North America, along with a full line of IR control products for both AV and security use, including our Aria audio distribution, which we'll be talking about today, accompanied with a full line of high-performance speakers, as well as being a licensed manufacturer of A-Bus audio technology, manufacturer of whole house intercoms, surveillance solutions, and Channel Vision exclusive technology. Now today we're going to go over a few different things. We're going to talk about how you can select the best multi-room audio system for your specific application, no matter what you encounter. We're going to talk about upselling opportunities. So once you get that job, you can offer your customers some enhancements to help make you guys a little more margin while you're at it. We'll talk a little bit about some application-based designs, as well as some common challenges that you may encounter while you're in the field. And the bottom line is that we're going to have a different solution to fit any of your multi-room audio needs. Now, this training here will take us about 45 minutes or so, and we will have sections available for questions and answers. Due to the fact that not everybody has microphones, you can type your questions in as you have them, and we'll address them when the time is appropriate. In the event we don't answer all your questions, we will have this session available as a recorded session, as well as follow up with each of you individually afterwards. With that being said, the first question is, how do you know when you need multi-room audio? One example is the music is turned up so loud at a party that you can hear it from another room, but you cannot talk in the same room where the speakers are. You carry a boombox from room to room, or you hear silence. Few typical reasons when you might identify that you need a distributed audio system. So we're going to look at four distributed audio methods today. We're going to talk about A-Bus Cat 5 audio. We're going to talk about Channel Vision's high-powered Cat 5 audio system. We're also going to talk about traditional Class A, B amplifiers, as well as wireless retrofit solutions so you can win any job. We're going to look at a good, better, and best option, so no matter what you encounter, you'll be able to get the job. With that being said, we're going to begin with A-Bus. Now, A-Bus is an industry standard, not something exclusive to Channel Vision. A-Bus is a technology implying that audio and power and IR all travel over a single Cat 5 using a local zone amplifier, which is your keypad. Now, with that being said, why would you want to go with an A-Bus system? Well, for starters, audio quality. Each amplifier, which is in the keypad, uses the digital processing technique, so you're going to get very good quality sound, and it's going to be directly located in the zone of the speakers. A-Bus is a technology that has been around for a while and has a proven track record of success for performance, as well as reducing your callbacks and the need to roll the truck. It makes your installs faster and easier, using a third of the single install time of a traditional distributed audio system, and gives you the ability to install with confidence, knowing that you have the support and the products that are going to perform. So with that being said, what's unique about Channel Vision's A-Bus if it's not something exclusive to Channel Vision? Well, one thing is that we're a licensed manufacturer. All of these products are designed in the USA and manufactured at our manufacturing facility. We also have the ability to add an iPod dock as a local source or part of a multi-room system. Channel Vision also has the ability to add a subwoofer and include it in remote zones so that you can sell more subwoofers. In addition to that, we have the ability to add 100 watts in any zone, new or existing if you need more power. So if you look at the anatomy of an A-bus system, you're going to start with the source. In this example, a CD player. From the CD player, you'll run with audio cables to a source input. From there, you'll use a Cat5 to a distribution hub, which will have power. And from that point, you will use a single Cat5 up to 300 feet away to your keypad, which happens to be your amplifier. And from your amplifier, you'll be able to connect directly to your speakers. And that's the basic outline of how an A-bus system works. To take a look at the anatomy of the keypad real quick, you'll look here and you'll see that it's kind of a green technology because it uses low power consumption when the unit's not in use. What's nice about it also is it fits into a single gang box with a decor style faceplate and the ability to have backlit buttons describing your audio level. You'll be able to use the same keypad for single or multi-source systems. Using an IR control system built into it, you can control the sources directly from the keypad via a remote control if you so choose. If you were to look at the back of the unit, you would see that it has some unique features. Here you'll have a left and right audio balance, as well as an RJ45 or 110 input, because we don't want to tell you how you have to install your job or what you're more comfortable doing. In addition to that, we have removable speaker connections. This makes installing a much easier task rather than bending over while the wire is hanging out on the wall. It gives you a chance to terminate the wire and then just plug it in, as well as having jumper selectable volume controls so that you can set the default level for when the unit powers on so there's no blaring if the children tend to have the volume a little higher than you may like. So these are just a couple engineering things that we do a little different than some other A-bus manufacturers. When you're looking at a system, we mentioned that that the keypad is the amplifier. Therefore, your speakers will get connected directly to the amplifier with a pair of 16-2 or 16-4 speaker wire, obviously pairing for two pairs of speakers per keypad. Now, with an A-bus system, you have options. You can start with a one-source system. With our one-source system, we have a distribution model that looks something like this. We have a couple other options in this category. But this unit right here will give you the opportunity to be rack or enclosure mountable depending on your install, allow you to do one source up to four zones, which is expandable as well. And again, you can use the RJ45 or 110 connectors. They're bridge connectors, so it's just a matter of what's more convenient for you. In addition to that, the one source system has a local and priority system selectable inputs, which I'll touch more on in just a moment, as well as having the ability to expand to additional units, up to 16 rooms of audio, as well as having four common IR emitter outputs to control any equipment that is included, as well as a power supply to make it easier to get things rolling. Now, with that being said, we have a couple other items that you can look into a system, and then we'll see how it all goes together. Looking at the AB301, which is a local source input module. This is another unique model from Channel Vision. That's going to offer you a flush mount design that fits into a single gang source. Single gang decor style plate. It's going to give you a single source input and allow you to have two emitter outputs. Now this can be used both as a global source in the hub or as a local source override, again, which I'll talk about in just a second, as well as having the line level audio inputs with the 110 punch downs on the back. Also going to give you a status and IR indicator to make sure your device is communicating properly. So when you're using these two items in the system together, it would look something like this. So here we have our source, which is our CD player, and then we have our distribution hub. So we can plug the CD player in directly to the AB301, the local source input module, and then run Cat5 back to the distribution hub. This is the perfect application in the event that your equipment is not located at the same place that your distribution center is. For example, if your distribution center or your P1014 hub here is located in the basement, but your source is located in the living room, you can use this AB module here, the 301, and just use a single Cat5 instead of having to run RCAs all the way down to the basement, which is an alternative that you have as well. Now, we also mentioned that we have a priority switch. So when would I use that? Well, this is an audio input priority switch, which you can use either to Cat5 or the RCA input simply by having this switch selected. Based on the selection that you have, the device plugged into each input will take priority over the other. For example, in the event that you had two sources plugged in, such as a CD player and maybe a wireless Bluetooth adapter or any other source for that matter, plugged into our 301 local input module. In this example, my switch is flipped up to my AB301. So in the event that my CD player is playing, everybody in these four rooms will hear the CD player. However, if a source is detected in the AB301, it will interrupt the CD player and take priority. So now that all four sources would now hear the AB301 source input. It's just a priority selectable switch so that you can automatically add a source that you want. Another instance that you might encounter this is in the event that a customer wanted to use their iPod. Your iPod is the AB315, is the current model, and this fits into a 2-gang low voltage box. As shown here, it's next to a keypad, which will result in a 3-gang solution. Now, you can use this the same way as we just discussed. For example, here, using the iBus override, in this example here, you have your CD player playing in all four rooms and everybody's happy. You come home from work, it's tired, you've been a long day, you want to listen to some Pandora, you dock your iPhone or your iPod right here on your dock, and this will take priority and interrupt the CD player so that all four rooms can hear your music from your iPod. Now this is an example of using the iPod dock as a global source, implying that all rooms can hear the same source. You can also use this system as what's called a local source. So here's the same hub that we were just looking at with our source plugged into it with satellite radio using Cat5 distributed to all the rooms. Here you see it distributed to one room. So in this example, my satellite radio can be heard in this one room. When I dock my iPod in this one room, it's heard just in that room. So that's a unique way where you can add a second source to the system. Now, take that to a second room, a third room, or even a fourth room, and you can give everybody in the house a unique solution exclusive to them. So in this example here, everybody can hear the satellite radio playing until they dock their iPod in this specific room. Now, when you're docking your iPod here, you hear your iPod just in that room. So now think for a moment about some applications that you might be able to use this in, beyond the residential application. You can use this in condos, dorm rooms, dentist offices, tanning salons. There's a plethora of different applications that you can utilize this system here, and all you need to do is run a single Cat5 to each room. So how successful has this application been? Well, very successful. Just to give you a quick little overview of some success stories we have, we've done 400 condos in Virginia using a two-zone system with an iPod, just for example with a condo complex. We did all of Arizona State dorm rooms with 120 single-room audio systems with iPod docks. We've done multiple Massage NV branches to provide them with 12 zones of audio. We've even utilized a similar system in Earl Williams Middle School to provide 25 classrooms with a local input for their audio, as well as offering 45 patients in Maryland the ability to have an iPod dock specifically in their room so they can listen in comfort. As I mentioned, we do have a handful of commercial applications available for you as well, including dentist offices, tanning salons, day spas, and condos. So even if you just do residential work, you can take this outside the box and be able to make money on your light commercial applications as well. As I mentioned, it is really easy to expand it. So in the event you said, Troy, I have 8 rooms of audio. What do I do? Just buy another one and plug it in. That's all there is to it. Simple Cat5 jumper allows you to expand this up to 16 zones of audio. And to make things really easy for you, we took these popular products and we put them in a box. So, for example, you have the AB902 kit, which includes 4 keypads, the source input, the distribution model, as well as the remote control, and the emitters, and even the tool to punch it down. Everything that you need to get the job done. In addition to that, we have the four-source kit also, so that you can expand this to additional rooms or add additional sources. One note I will add is just because you are expanding the zones to additional music locations, you will not be adding any additional sources. So the most sources you can have is four global sources and then as many local sources as you'd like. Now, there's a whole bunch of different applications we could get into with ABUS that I'm not even going to be able to get into today. There's ways that you can integrate this into a paging system. We can integrate the subwoofers into each additional zones. You can add additional speakers and more power into zones, as well as using wireless integration with adapters as your sources, and give you a handful of different options when it comes to that. So just a quick little snapshot review of ABUS. Looks a little something like this. It's a great option because it uses simple, easy-to-use Cat5 wiring. It's a perfect option for your background music or distributed audio, which is exactly what most customers are looking for, and it's going to give you the ability to add local sources and additional equipment in the systems. You can integrate it with your iPhone in each of the zones, and it will play nice with Airport Express or any other wireless application. And that's ABUS in a nutshell. Great opportunity for you guys to make a little more money, and very, very good SKU that's very reliable. It'll ensure good success with you. With that being said, I'll pause for a quick moment so we can take a look and see if there's any questions that we have. Just give me 2 seconds here. What we see here is there's a question here is, your kit showed a different model than the P1014 that you were just discussing. Yes, we have an alternative option, which is the first system that we looked at when we were doing a basic ABUS installation system, and that's the one source four zone system. And the reason we include that system is because it makes it easier to do a simple installation, easier as part of a structured wiring solution in the event that you're going to put this stuff in a structured wiring enclosure box, which of course we manufacture also, and provides another alternative for you. To answer the question, we do not have that P1014 in a kit, but we do have two alternatives for your single source distribution systems. There's another question here that does your ABUS system work with other manufacturers' ABUS products? The technical answer that I'll give you in regard to that is that the Channel Vision ABUS is an industry standard implying audio and power over Cat5. Some manufacturers may have a few other wires inverted or reversed, for example. However, there is no indication that anything is not compatible with each other. Here's another question that what is the length of the wire from a P1014 to a 301? As with any Cat5 system, you don't want to run Cat5 audio or Cat5, anything over Cat5 for that matter, much more than 300 feet just to ensure the audio integrity and the quality of everything that you're getting. Another question is that can I use Cat5 or Cat6? The technical answer is it doesn't matter. Both of those are backwards compatible. You're just going to get a little bit better transmission speed on your Cat6. So it's not really going to affect the performance to answer the question. Looks like we covered a majority of the questions right now. We do have to move on to another section. So in the event that I did not answer any of your questions, don't worry, we will come back to that part as well. So here's moving on to the portion of our Aria distribution system here. Now what you're looking at here is our A0350. Now this is one of the best kept secrets in the industry and one of our more popular SKUs. So let me tell you a little about this piece right here. The A0350 here fits into a 2-gang low voltage box, and this allows you to provide 100 watts of power in a specific room. So let me elaborate. Here on the back of the unit, you'll have a speaker connection, as well as the ability to provide 100 watts, 50 watts per channel. In addition to that, you can use it as the outputs as a preamp for a subwoofer, if it's not a powered subwoofer. You also have a speaker level adjustment to adjust the audio quality, as well as an auto-sensing power circuitry, so the unit will power down when not in use in order to conserve power. You'll have a Cat5 input as well as a volume input for a keypad, so two Cat5 inputs on the back, which I'll elaborate on in just a moment. You'll have power options also that you can wire everything in the back in the event that you don't want to use the speaker's outputs in the front or any of the other power inputs in the front. In addition to the front input, you're also going to have a local audio input. This is also a priority override. So similar in stature to what we talked about earlier with an A-bus system, this is a little different because here this is the amplifier, not the keypad. So you can have your Cat5 audio source plugged into the back and have an additional source input in the front. Just note that when the source in the input is in the front is used, it will take priority over the Cat5 source. So how would I use this? Well, it's a very, very great solution for a single room application where you can have a keypad next to your iPod dock, use a Cat5 wire. In this example, you should run two Cat5 wires down to your amplifier, one for the keypad and one for the iPod dock, just as we shown earlier. And from that point, you can go out to your speakers, allowing you to have a single zone of audio where you could even add a subwoofer if you wanted to. This is a great solution for any application. If you want to put it with a pool house, again, all the same applications we talked about, condos. We just did 400 of these in Virginia. We did 200 of these in Florida, 300 in Ohio. And again, this is a very popular application for the building market. Great opportunity for condos, townhomes, pool houses, kids' rooms, or any application where you just need a single source of audio without all the extra equipment. Now, I can't even tell you how inexpensive this is, but I can tell you that it's the best deal that you'll find for everything here. We put it in a kit that allows you to have a keypad, the iPod dock, a pair of speakers, and a 100-watt two-channel amplifier, all for a very aggressive price that will allow you to make money and win plenty of jobs. So with that being said, we're going to transition a little more into the Aria audio system, which is our high-performance for high-profit option. Now, within the Aria system here, you're going to look at a traditional Class AB amplifier, which is the type of amplification that it uses. These are also going to be rack-mountable in a traditional rack-style system, and also is going to be able to integrate with many of the home automation systems such as Control 4, Constitutes, as well as a few other options. And it's going to give you a cost-effective, versatile solution to be able to spec in for your jobs. As well as the options to expand it up to 18 zones, this solution can be a very aggressive model for a variety of different applications. To begin, we'll look at the amplifier itself. The A1260 is a 12-channel amplifier. So in this application, you're going to have up to 60 watts per channel. That's 120 watts per room. And this is going to have the ability to give you one stereo input distributed to six zones, as well as have global and selectable source options available. So a little different than the A-bus system that we looked at earlier that had Cat5 home runs and then speaker wire to your amplifier. Remember, in the audio system, the speakers will always connect to your amplifier. So in this application, you ask your customer, what wiring do you currently have in place? Well, I only have speaker wire home runs from the speaker back to my audio room. Well, if that's the case, this is the system for you. Here you can see in the back of the A1260 that you have both global and local inputs. Now this is a little different than the priority override on the other system that we talked about, and I'll elaborate a little more on that in just a second. But an example would be here that you plug your source in to your RCA global input on the back, and then just using speaker wire to each of the zones, you would have an impedance matching volume control, which would then be able to power the speakers and control the volume directly. Now you can hook additional speakers up to this volume control, but this will give you the opportunity to expand to six zones without making anything too complicated. Now back to that global input we were talking about. This is a selectable switch. So what I mean by that, as with the A-bus system we looked at earlier, when you were to plug in your local source and have that switch plugged in, it would automatically interrupt the global source and play the local source through all the zones. This application is a little bit different. By flipping this switch manually, you can add an additional source to each of the zones. So for example here, everybody can hear all source one, but when you plug in the local source and you flip the switch, it'll be heard just in zone six. Just mind you, that is a manual switch that you would use. Say, okay, Troy, now what if I want a more elaborate keypad or I have a different wiring configuration? Well, the good news is we have a system for that too. We'd be talking about our multi-source, multi-zone options. In this application here, we have the same amplifier that we just looked at. However, we're adding an additional matrix. Now, the concept of the matrix is to allow any zone to listen to any source independently of the other. So that's the concept of a matrix. So when you add a matrix in conjunction with the amplifier, you have a high-powered, multi-source, multi-room audio system that you can use for just about any application. So the way it'll work is starting with the matrix itself. This will allow you to plug in four different sources and distribute them to six different zones. This will also have audio video input, so you can also use composite video to distribute a composite video source or a digital audio source such as digital coax. In addition to that, you can use the Control 4 drivers or Costa-Tune drivers to integrate with your home automation system by using the RS-232 connection. And in the event that you're going to expand them, there's an IR link cable to ensure the communication is the same throughout the system. Looking at the keypad here, this is the A127 keypad, and this unit is going to function just like a wired remote control. Here, you'll have Cat5 connected to the back of the keypad, and you'll have all the sources that you would expect, or control features that you would expect to have on your remote control, including the volume up and down buttons, the ability to mute and shut off the system, as well as select your sources manually by directly choosing the source, as well as powering the unit off to shut off your video and audio, as well as an IR window that you could look into the future, control your other devices, as well as send relays from the couch. So a great opportunity to make things a little bit easier using Cat5. Now, with that being said, we just talked about three different things. So how does it all go together? Well, in this application, you would have your sources plugged into your audio matrix on the top, the 4603. You would use one of the outputs to go into the input of your amplifier. And from this point, you have your Cat5 connected to your keypad. So in this example, Cat5 and keypad, or Cat5 and speaker wire home runs to your system will provide the ability to offer you multiple sources and multiple zone distributed audio system. Now, if you're thinking these two components look like they might be a little pricey, I'll tell you, first of all, they're not, but I'll give you an alternative option also. We also have an amp preamp combo. This is our A4623. It's a less expensive option with a little bit less power, but it's going to give you all the same functionality that we just discussed. Here you're going to get four sources to six zones with expansion up to 18 zones, again using your AV inputs, again using your drivers for Costa-Tunes with RS-232. This difference here is that this is going to give you 40 watts per zone as opposed to 120. Just basically took the two and squished them together into one. But it's definitely going to provide you a great low-cost option that you could fit into your rack, distribute your audio system, whether you're doing a bar application or a home distributed audio system. Both options will be there for you. Again, just using your sources plugged into the inputs and using simple Cat5 and speaker wire home runs to your keypads and your speakers, and you have a basic system for distributed audio. Now, when it comes to speakers, we know that you have your choice. But ChannelVision does offer a variety of different speakers in all different shapes and sizes, including 5 1/4 inch, 6 1/2 inch, and 8 inch in ceiling, as well as in wall speakers, LCR speakers, outdoor speakers, as well as custom angled speakers as well. So you have a whole gamut of different options. We'll have some low cost solutions as low as $37 to the dealer, as well as a high powered Kevlar option for a ridiculous price too low to even mention. Now, with that being said, you have another different option that you can integrate as well. In the event that you're using ChannelVision speakers or a variety of different systems, we just introduced our new on-wall dock for the iPad. And since it's in the Aria category, I certainly want to mention this now. So in the event you're using some of our audio systems as part of a Control 4 system, for example, you can now utilize your iPad as your control device. Here you'll see the iPad dock, which will allow you to control all of your home automation systems. You can even display your favorite photo when the iPad is removed with the photo that will stay in the dock behind you. It will allow you to charge your iPod while it's docked. You can mount it securely, vertically or horizontally, and makes it super easy to use your cameras. So what's nice about this system here is that it's going to fit into a three-gang box. Great, easy solution, which doesn't require any proprietary holes or boxes. From that three-gang box, you just run it to a single Cat 5 cable, and then you'll be able to integrate with any of your communication system from your apps. You will be using Wi-Fi for your integration, so you will have the ability to charge your iPod, or I'm sorry, your iPad, while using your docking control station to view your cameras, control your audio sources, listen to Pandora, turn your lights off, or any application that you may come across for a very, very aggressively priced iPad dock. With that being said, there is a handful of things for you to take a look at in the Aria category. So like I said, we covered a lot of stuff so far. We talked about the ability to get you 120 watts using your traditional wiring, such as Cat 5 and speaker wire home runs. You can use an additional 100 watts into an existing zone by using that double gang single zone audio kit that we mentioned, as well as the ability to add a subwoofer with some additional systems in there as well. Gives you the ability to control and add equipment from any room in the house, and it's going to give you a great option when it comes to distributed audio using a traditional system. Now, with that being said, I'll take a look at a couple questions real quick, and then we'll wrap up with our wireless audio distribution portion of it, talk about how you guys can make money in that aspect of it well. Here's a question regarding the iPhone. So everybody knows that Apple has recently released a new iPod and iPhone, which uses a different connector than the traditional 30-pin. All of our iPod docks today do use the existing 30-pin connector. Anyway, we expect that transition to be there for a little while until the new models and the new connectors gain a little more traction. Some of the benefits of existing setups is that you can easily use a third-party device to connect that 30-pin to the new Lightning connector and still be able to charge and play the sources. We've already tested that. Alternatively, once that transition happens, we'll be able to simply switch out our dock connectors by using a different ribbon cable and dock connector that's in the system. So wouldn't worry too much about that. Here's a question regarding the exterior application. Are these products weather resistant? I'll answer that question by saying we do have outdoor speakers. However, some of these keypads and things that we're discussing are not designed to be outdoor. However, this is a custom industry, and I'm sure I know it's been done. But there are the technical answer from the manufacturers that these are not outdoor rated. But due to the fact that you do have the IR relays, there are a couple different options you can do to design a custom system, and we can certainly help with that as well. If we don't have any additional questions at the moment, we may be able to transition to another portion of it here. So with that being said, let me move us into our last portion here of our wireless audio system. With that being said, why should you go wireless? Well, for one reason, it's a whole lot less work. It gives you the opportunity to win every job and achieve what was previously believed to be impossible. So now this solution is not designed for every install, obviously. I mean, anytime you want to use a distributed audio system, you certainly have that option. But we all have certainly come across an application where we either can't run the wires or it's an afterthought or something else like that, which may allow us to use the wireless system. So there's a lot of opportunities for this in both the commercial space with warehouse distribution, on-hold music, paging systems, piping in music, as well as the quiet rooms. We've done a few of these at churches as well. On the residential side, it's probably a little more apparent. Anybody that has hardwood floors, you want an outdoor zone, something that they forgot earlier. You want to do a distributed audio system but don't have all of the equipment or wires run. The perfect retrofit solution, which is a big theme nowadays, as well as in the event of concrete slabs where you can't run that wire, this certainly is a viable option for you. So the bottom solution is that this is a problem solver. No, that's not my wife yelling at me, but she certainly would be yelling at me if I was told that I had to pay $800 to run a trench out to the pool house to be able to run conduit from my speakers. I'd be a little upset. So this is where this application may come in. So So now the question comes up of wireless audio. How good is it? How reliable is it? Well, let's start with a little bit of background about audio. So when you're looking at audio, analog versus digital, a wave audio form looks something like this here. Now, in the event you're injecting audible noise, which can be picked up from cordless phones, microwaves, baby monitors, Wi-Fi, anything for that matter, you have a distorted signal, which causes poor audio quality and loss of signal. So what have we done to make this problem go away? Well, we started with the digital transmission. So here you have your wavelength form, and what we're doing here is sending digital packets of information. Think of this like buffering. So we're sending a full packet, for example, the first 40 seconds of a song. So in the event there are any interruptions or noise interference, you'll have that buffer to be able to ensure that you have the full quality of music the whole time. In addition to that, there's the analog versus digital transmission sequence. So within this 2.4 frequency that we're operating in, we provide 8 different channels that you can jump in between in order to ensure that you have a solid signal. We understand that there are other devices that operate in the 2.4 spectrum, and this gives you the opportunity to select the choice that's the least interference in the event that you do encounter anything like that. Now, another thing in regards to quality that we talked about is delay. So far we've talked about the quality of the audio, the integrity of the signal, the ability to avoid interference. There's also what we talked about, which is latency, which is in regards to delay. So 64 milliseconds is acceptable from some other audio manufacturers. You also have an 8 seconds, which is about the typical shutter speed of a camera. 5 milliseconds, which is the bee's wing flap. And then there's 3.8 milliseconds, which is the latency of the channel vision wireless audio. What this translates into is there's no delay in our wireless audio system. When you look at the anatomy of the two units here, you'll see you have a couple different options. Here is a transmitter-receiver pair, and this is one of our options for distributed audio from a one-to-one standpoint where you have one source going to one location. So you have the frequency hopping technology built into both models. You have the ability to have your transmitter with a line-level input, power, LED signal, channel selection, and on your receiver, you'll have your signal strength indicator, power input, audio input, and then you also have the option for a speaker-level input on your transmitter. So you can transmit speaker-level or line-level up to 300 feet away to your wireless receiver with a line-level out to go to any audio system. Now, please note, you do still need power for the units. Just because this is wireless doesn't mean you don't need power. Until they figure out how to put wireless power, you'll be limited to a few cords at the very least. I think they do call it lightning, but I think we'll have to wait for that solution. Alternatively, you saw that the other unit had an RCA out, implying that you need to go to an amplifier. Then I'll tell you a little why we have that application done in just a moment. Alternatively, you also have a point-to-point wireless amplified receiver. You'll see here that this fits into a 3-gang low voltage box and gives you all the abilities that we looked at a little bit earlier. Here you can still add a subwoofer, you can add a local source input, you can use a keypad to control this amplifier if it's a little further away, depending on your application, as well as having the power supply plugged in to the front or the back at your discretion. Now, we'll talk about a few different applications for wireless audio and when you might use this system. There's a one-to-one system, which, as we mentioned, will transmit line level or speaker level up to 300 feet away to a wireless transmitter, just using an RCA out to go into any amplified system. So, if you were to do a wireless rear speaker, it would look a little something like this. You have your source plugged in, and then up to 300 feet away, you have your wireless receiver, line level out to an amplifier connecting your speakers. Here it's shown with a small little amplifier that Channel Vision also offers for a similar solution to this specific application. Alternatively, in the event that you have a different amplifier, you can use that as well. The whole concept here is enables you to deliver the source from one location to another without using wires. Alternatively, you can use it as a source for the speaker system directly. In this application, you can have your source plugged in via RCAs. Send that up to 300 feet away to your receiver, which has an amplifier connected to it, and then utilizing the volume control to adjust the volume on the speakers. This is a really good application, and probably one of our most common, is to utilize for a wireless subwoofer application. Assuming that it's a powered subwoofer, you can have the sub out from your amplifier, your receiver, home theater receiver, plugged into the transmitter. Up to 300 feet away, your wireless subwoofer plugged in, and be able to get those low frequencies wirelessly by using the sub switch on the back. We also have a different system, which is designed to do one to unlimited. This is more of a broadcast system and has a couple different applications. So here you would have your main source distributed to as many rooms as you'd like. In this application, it makes it really easy to add an existing zone. So maybe you have your 12-channel system that we looked at earlier, but oh, shucks, we forgot to add that system in the patio. Well, that's easy enough. You can just plug in your transmitter and then have your amplifier and receiver at an alternative location and be able to add that zone fairly easily. Now, we'd like that we have had a lot of success with this application. And we also give you the ability to use a wireless RF remote control and able to control your sources and your volume of your signal just by using the wireless RF frequency on your wireless remote. Now, this is a remote manufactured by Nevo UEI, which Genovision still has available for any customers in need. As I mentioned, we have had a few success stories. This is just a quick little one about a Laguna Beach homeowner who sought to have music by the pool. The first option was to trench the garden at a cost that came in just about $800. With a little over $100 worth of wireless audio products, the garden was saved and the outdoor speakers installed, and a very, very happy customer. So in the event that you're out there in the field and you encounter some problems, there's a few things that you might want to take a test with. If you're getting any cracking and humming, you could have just a little interference from some of your other audio signals. Just change the channel. If the distance is not reaching 300 feet, this is we've tested at 400 feet open set field of view. However, different structures do break down the signal a little more than others. Here in California, we do not have brick or plaster, so those tend to diminish the signal a little bit. Try adding another option there for moving a little closer. If your light's fluctuating, you could just have a little bit of distance issues or interference. There is also an audio sense activation system in it. In the event that you're trying to use a low source signal, such as an iPod, for example, you might have to manually flip the switch on the wireless audio system in order to detect that low incoming signal. To give you a quick little snapshot on everything that we talked about today with the wireless audio in a nutshell, we have options for you from one source to an unlimited number of zones. But it gives you a great application to use with a wireless subwoofer, to add an existing zone to another system, or to create an audio system. Bottom line is that you can balance the transfer or the trade-off between running the wires and doing a wireless audio system. Like I said, the bottom line here is that we're here to provide solutions. So to give you a quick review, we talked about a lot of stuff today. We talked about Cat 5 audio and an A-bus solution, which allows you to distribute audio over Cat 5. We also have a high-powered Cat 5 audio system, which uses the local zone input, which is a little something we didn't get too deep into today, but I wanted to spare you because I know you guys all have things to do today. Great options to add to an existing audio to an existing install, allows you to provide amplification for high power using your Class A and B amplifiers, as well as give you the option to add a wireless system anyways. So no matter what wiring is in place, you'll be able to accommodate the system. With that being said, we're just about wrapping up here, but just to make things easier for you guys, we do have 24/7, 365 support. So if you're ever out in the field experiencing any of these problems or any problem on any channel vision product for that matter, please give us a call 24 hours a day. We're here to serve you. We do have options for 1- and 10-year warranties, as well as options to expand your warranties, which we'll be letting more information about shortly. We do offer free training, so if somebody charged you to be here today, do ask for a refund, because we are not charging for these trainings. but we do offer a free system design as well, which will make things a little bit easier for you if you need help designing the system, whether it's a distributed audio system, a video surveillance application, or a structured wired enclosure. We're here to help. And that's something that we can do for you guys free of charge. Just give us about 24 hours to turn it around, and we'll send you everything that you need to get the job done. In addition to that, you can download the Channel Vision application guide from channelvision.com. This is our short-form, full-line catalog, if you will, which will give you all the products that we talked about today, as well as some of their applications and use. If you really want to know what's going on, you should check us out here and follow us on Facebook. Be a fan. Like us. We have friends. We need more friends. We like friends. You can also follow us on Twitter for some of the top secret latest releases and promotions that we're running, as well as catch a full line of our trainings available on our Channel Vision YouTube channel. Again, if you have any other questions or anything like that, feel free to contact us directly here at Channel Vision. We are here for your support. You can reach the number on the screen, send us over an email. We're always here and available. With that being said, I'll let you guys get back to your day. Like I said, if I apologize if we didn't answer all of your questions, we'll be able to accommodate those at a later date and follow up with you personally. But stay tuned. We are going to have some trainings upcoming as well, so take a look at our training page. We'll be doing some CDS-certified IP training coming up here in a month or two, so certainly stay tuned for that, and we certainly appreciate your time and service. Thank you, and make it a great day.